Grandmaster Rafael Leitao from Brazil finished his game in the match against Macedonia. Can you tell us something about the game?
Well, my opponent played one opening I was not expecting, and well, I tried to make some creative moves to get out of preparation, and maybe I got slightly better position, but I'm not sure. But then at critical moment, he just played some queen g5 that was bad, and he blundered, and immediately, in one move, I was winning like at least 3 points, I think, from computer.
How is your team doing?
Well, second board was in endgame, was a pawn down. I don't know if he can manage to hold. I hope so. And third board was, I think, between equal and slightly worse. And fourth board, I had complete mess. I could not understand anything.
Is Alex Fier still blitzing his opponent, or he's thinking a bit longer?
No, in this tournament, he it seems like he's playing slower, but anything can happen in these games. It's good for spectators, but not for teammates.
Okay, Rafael, you're now the current champion of Brazil. You have four or five titles, of course, five titles, and Vescovi is seven titles. So is this race continuing, and who will emerge victorious in the end?
Well, the first time I played against Vescovi, I was 7 and he was 8. So it's a long time rivalry, and I think it will continue. And he's 2 titles ahead. Also, Milos has, I think, 7 titles or 6, I don't know. So I'll try to catch up, but it's always very difficult. They are very, very good players.
What are the ambitions of Brazil team here in the Olympiad?
Well, last time we were on place 17, so we wish to improve that. It's very difficult, but now our team is improved. Vescovi did not play the last Olympiad, and I think if everybody's on form, then we can play very good Olympiad. But the last ones, nobody played well, so I hope this time we can do it.
Only a few days after the Olympiad, Sao Paulo Final Masters is starting. Will you be following the tournament? Can you feel an excitement in Brazil about this event?
Actually, not much. I mean, the problem with Sao Paulo is a very big city, and there is not so much interest in chess, but I hope they can manage to make some media about this. Unfortunately, I will be in Venezuela playing an open tournament, so I won't be around during the tournament, but it's very good to popularize chess in Brazil, and hope they keep doing this tournament.
I know that Vescovi is involved in some project chess in schools, and that you also have your own school. How is Brazil development in this domain, to introducing chess to children?
Well, Brazil is a very big country, so in some places it's developing very well, especially on south and southeast of Brazil. But I'm living now in the northeast, and very far away from São Paulo, and there is nothing about chess, nobody plays it. So I'm trying to increase popularity of chess in this town, and maybe make something with children. But in general, on this part of Brazil south, it's developing very well. Maybe we'll have some very good players in some time.
We remember that you were making tours in open tournaments in Europe, but we haven't seen you recently. Why is the reason?
Well, the last time I did this was 2006, I think, and then I was married, and I didn't want to travel for so long, and I was doing my other things. So I'm more interested right now in teaching and other strong players and playing myself. Although, of course, if Brazil starts making some good tournaments, I will play it. But if I have to travel and spend 1 month away, I'm not interested anymore.